Hello everyone. Today I thought I would make the card with you for with the background I made last time. Remember I used a stencil from a surprise and also a shape, a circle, to get this effect. And here I have prepared a card base 6x6, and this paper was 5¾, you remember? And I think black will pop really nice, and just so not take away from the background, I think I just want to have a little flower in silhouette like this, something. Let's see, we glue this on first and like so. And the flower, I want to that it will overlap from the background and the sentiment too. Tack means thank you in Swedish. And I will glue the flower down. So, and then for the sentiment, try to and then I want to take some adhesive pearls on the outside somewhere in pink and yellow, I think. Oh, that hot pink. Great. And yellow. And maybe a love it. And maybe three here. And another yellow. Now I have another idea. I will be back when I have prepared it. So, I have prepared a little fun project, I think. I got the idea when I was die-cutting this, a DL or slimline card die. It's two dies, a frame and an inside. But those circles cut out too. So I get 3 Slimline DL cards. I have prepared here. On this one, I have the frame. On this, I have the inner without the circles. And on this last card, I have the circles, inner circles. And I think you can make lots of fun cards if you just look at the die sets and yeah, the ideas comes, I promise you. Let's start. I start with this one. This is A4 size card. I just, on the long side, I cut down to 8 and scored in half. So it's 4 and 8 and a quarter. And then I had a scrap piece, and that I thought was perfect for this. I use Let Spring Begin by Craft Consortium. I just have bits and pieces left now. I have used it a lot, as you can tell on the videos I have shared. And now I will try and... Well, it won't be noticeable, I think. You be careful when you take the paper. Maybe it's better to... Let's see. I want an even border. I make a mess. Now it's more even. Like so. And this I will have some foam tape. And put on. I don't know who will get these cards, so the sentiments will be later on. But I thought it was a fun idea to show you a die set and what you can do with it. There. I made a card with the frame, and now for card number 2, I have prepared here. I think I will have the bees from the Let Spring Begin. It's the same collection, so I think they are so cute. I think I can have them somewhere. And I will start with this. I don't know if I want to have the inner circles with the patterning paper on a 3D foam, maybe. Let's see if I... Yay! Maybe I... Yeah, I think I will have them on 3D foam. Just to make an interest. And now we have to center this. I think those paper are so cute. So I just have small bits and pieces. And then what is more great than making scrap cards? At the same time when you're using a dieset. Like so. And now I will put the bees on my thing. There. And this will be there. And then I will have one in the middle on one of the flowers, I think. Like so. That's number two. Ready? Hope you can see it. And now for the last card. Here I have the circles, and then I have some images I cut out from the paper pack, and I cut out a circle 4 3/8 of an inch in diameter, and then I cut that in half like this, and then I thought I would maybe have it like so, and then the other stuff on top. I love this polka dots paper. Color makes me happy. We love making cards with lots of colors and bling, of course. Now for these, I think I will have the circles on foam, and then the images on tape. Think like so. I just said I would have 3D foam and taking glue anyway. Oh well, I caught it in time. I have too many ideas in my head, and sometimes it clash. So so I don't remember what I say. Like there. And then I think it's easier to... down the other edge circle. It's easier to get it even, I think. And put down the last circle. So, yeah, I'm happy with that. And then this will be there, and that will be there, and the toadstool in the middle. It's cute, I think. I will have tape for this. It's easier for the glitter card to take tape. Super cute. And now, but it should show it's handmade, don't you think? There, and then the toadstool. So, maybe I will have some no, I'm happy with how it turned out. So, these three cards I have made with you, plus I finished the other one with the colored background. Let me know in the comments which card is your favorite one, two, or three, or maybe the first one. I showed you number four. Thank you for today, and I hope I will be back on Thursday. Have a great week. Bye.